Well, if you can't show your respects for the fallen of the Great War or for any other conflict on any side, really, then there's something wrong with you. So I think it's a good thing to show your respects. Those people that lost their lives in the First World War have fallen away from living memory now, and no one is alive now to remember them. Well, not many anyway. I had two great uncles that died in the First World War. My own grandfather was a stretcher bearer in the Somme during the First World War as well. So that's my link back to the Great War, the war to end all wars. And the more I think about it, the more that First World War was such a futile war, such a futile loss of life on both sides, really. And I think that, you know, mankind's in the hands of a few very powerful people. You know, the political classes, the ruling classes, the elites seem to dictate the route that the history follows. I remember my grandfather. I never knew my grandfather. He died in 1959. And I was born in 1962, but I still remember him. And I remember my what would be my great uncles, or great great uncles even, Hubert and Sidney. They were both killed as young men in the First World War. So I remember them. I remember the memory of them. Of course, I never knew them.
I suppose they would have been in a war, wouldn't they?
In the Great War.
Mm.
Yeah. Well, my dad was, wasn't he? Your granddad. He was at the Somme. Yeah.
I never knew that.
Neither did I till Uncle John told me.
Did I?
Yeah, I'd never thought of asking Dad.
So Granddad was in the Somme?
He did in the war. I knew he was something to do with the medical side of it. Mm. Yeah.
And then there was two great cousins, weren't there? The O'Neills or Neills, who were in the Great War as well. Hubert and Sidney.
Hubert and Sidney, yeah. They got killed.
Anyway, just an announcement, a couple of things. Firstly, my friend John Wellins Lever, and also John makes the Morse keys. He's asked me to give him a bit of a shout out and a heads up to anyone that's interested that John has to go into hospital in the coming week for an operation, and he's going to be unlikely to be able to do any lever work for a few months, probably two or three months at least, before he starts to feel well enough to continue with his lever work. And anyone interested in John's Morse keys, again, I don't think he's going to be able to produce any Morse keys for the foreseeable future. So he just asked me to give a heads up for that, because he says, you know, I'll reach more people with my subscriber base and get the word out there, get the message out there. So I think he goes in on the 15th for the operation. So if you can respect that, that'd be great. So I hope you'll all join with me in wishing John a speedy recovery. He has to have some sort of a bone graft, a graft to his jawbone. So that will take some getting over, I think. So all the best for that, John. I'm sure it will go well, and we look forward to seeing you back home and back enjoying life. What else was there? Oh yeah, the Mavic drone. Still waiting for mine. I'll tell you what, I've been watching all the videos on the internet now, and there's loads of them coming out now about the Mavic, and it seems that everyone in the world's getting theirs apart from us in England. People in the States have been getting them. They've had them now for the last two or three weeks. A few of them have been crashing them because they haven't. I think it's pilot error. They've not been calibrating their controllers or their drones properly, or they haven't been doing the firmware upgrades or updates. It's an extremely complex piece of kit, so you've got to know what you're doing before you fly it, really. I thought, you know, we were a great nation, Great Britain, we were a great nation at one point. We led the world, or so the history books tell us. But now, I'll tell you what, we're akin to a third world country, and we just, you know, having to wait for products like this coming from China. I think they're produced in China now. And we're this bottom of the pile. And not only are we bottom of the pile, we also pay the highest prices for these products. Over in the States, you can pick up a DJI Mavic for $999. Over here in the UK, you're looking at £1,099. And if you do the sums, that's approximately $1,400 in US money. So we get ripped off. Also, I recently found out that YouTube, I've monetized my videos. I make a little bit of money out of my videos. The money that I make out of my videos just about covers, it has just about covered my camera equipment costs since I've started, really. So I'm not making any great money out of it. But apparently, the YouTubers in America, they get more per click or whatever, however it works. They get more than we get in the UK. So I feel really done down. I don't do the videos just purely for monetization. It helps. But if they stop monetizing the videos, I still do them just out of my own for my own interest. It's a hobby, but the monetization helps. But the fact that we get our products last of all, the fact that we get paid less, the fact that we pay more taxes, the fact that it's harder to make progress in the UK, it just don't leave me feeling good about it, really. Anyway, I expect this is falling on deaf ears. I expect that a lot of you out there agree with me. But I don't know how to address the situation. It's just the way it is. If I want to buy anything for my business, for example, all the decent equipment, I've got to import it. That means probably buying it in from the States. And I get hammered. My dog's scratching over there. I get hammered by import duty. Don't seem fair. This country doesn't seem fair. Oh well, something to look forward to anyway. I'm going on an adventure tomorrow, so hopefully I'll upload some videos of that, and hopefully at some point in the next month or two I might get my Mavic. So that's about it. Hello, Ars. You can come and say hello. Oh, look, there she is. I know what you're up here for. She's up here because some of you know she's a bit of a tea leaf. And that's what she's up here for. My cup of tea. You want my cup of tea, don't you? That's what she wants. Come on, I'll put it on the floor for you. Come on. It does go against the grain a little bit, producing a slightly negative video, even though I think it's based on truth. So I do apologise for negative undertones of this video. I am a great believer in a positive mental attitude, though. Camera audio was picking up a lot of low frequency resonation, so I've changed the microphone out. Hopefully it sounds a bit better. I have overcome a lot of adversity in my own life as well. And I think a lot of that was down to a positive mental attitude, which is a real asset to have. One quick thing. I've been asked by I can hear that resonation again. I think it's the walls. I've been asked by Paul from Forest Prepper from Camp Shaky, would I give them a quick shout out? They're doing an auction, or is it a raffle? I'm not sure, one or the other. About with one of my knives, a Jack Roar Classic. I'll put a link in the description box to Paul's video, and I'll probably tag on a bit of the video on the end of this as well, so you get to see it. So there's a chance for anyone who's interested to go and get a Jack Law for a little money, and any money left over obviously goes to fund a very good cause. It goes to fund Camp Shaky because they're using it to buy new equipment for themselves, and this means that it's a group of individuals, a large number of people now, that will all benefit from this auction or raffle. So if you please support them, I'd be ever so grateful.
Hi guys, so if you want to enter the Camp Shaky Jack Law raffle this year, basically what it's done this year, we've asked Sandy, we've commissioned Sandy to make us a knife. It's an awesome knife, but like I said, if you go to the Camp Shaky website, there is a link to the video of the knife that Sandy made, but also there's a load of photos on it of the knife. The knife is made from stabilized yew wood. It features a teepel tang. It's a right-handed leather sheath with red stitching. It's got a belt dangler with it. It's got brass hardware and mosaic pings and red liners. The knife is worth about £280. But like I said, if you want to have a closer look at it, either go to the Camp Shaky website, have a look at the photos, but there's also a link to Sandy's video that he did of the knife, so you can have a look at it a bit more detail if you want to. Obviously, to purchase a ticket for the Camp Shaky Jack Law knife, the ticket price is £10 per ticket. There's no amount of tickets you can have, you can have as many as you want. The raffle is open worldwide. And let's see, yeah, and each ticket is one entry to the raffle. So say if you bought three tickets, that would be £30. Make sure obviously you provide your name, your YouTube name, and that obviously when you're doing your purchase for your ticket for the Jack Law raffle. And obviously we can make sure then we can send you confirmation and your ticket number within 48 hours so you've got it there. I mean, obviously, if you can't be there in person, we can post it to you. So it don't matter where you are in the world, we will post it to you. Obviously, if you live in America or anywhere else, obviously, there's going to be a charge, obviously, for postage. I mean, obviously, all the money we're going to be raising this year is going to go into the Camp Shaky Fund so we can buy new kit, so we can put on better events, better shows. This year we've already invested quite a bit of money on new event charts and stuff. It used to be myself and Richie that used to kind of put most of the money into getting the stuff done, but obviously I can no longer afford it. Richie only comes now and again now, so obviously we've had to look at other ways of sourcing an income to put on some of these great events and stuff. So hopefully anybody who wants a Jack Law will be willing to obviously spend £10. It's not a lot of money really to win a knife of its caliber, and obviously they are in short supply.
So anyway, new video coming out shortly. I'm off to Brecon on a wild camp with my friend Ant. We're planning on doing the major hills there, and then hopefully soon the DJI Mavic drone will arrive. Fingers crossed. Fingers crossed. Thanks for watching, everybody, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.